30 years, we're actually paying, it's costing us more to do a joint venture. We're going to continue to have ongoing expenses versus if the city owns it. Not to mention, the city would be giving up a huge asset if we sold and just had the air parcel. I just don't think that's good practice to do. That's my personal take on it.
I agree with Kelly. I think it's a huge asset, and I think that it would be something that the city probably would want to retain. And I think
I'm personally not in favor of the city being in competition with other businesses, but those numbers are startling. They really are.
Well, not to go way down the road, but look at the cities around us. The city of Montgomery, I spend millions of dollars on a pool facility. Well, there's a lot of swim clubs in there. You know, country clubs, everything else.
Carl, I understand exactly what you're saying.
It's an amenity for the city. Does it kill any other business? I don't know about that.
Yeah, I'm fine with what the group says. Again, as you said, Ken, it's really boils down to what your appetite for risk is. And there's some other side issues, like, you know, it's in the city asset, it's the city center, or the municipal building. Again, I typically have a low appetite for risk in the municipal setting, but, you know, one reason to maybe take that risk on is connecting it to what you were saying, sir, and you, Corey, you're protecting that and holding title to, you know, that site, that physical site. You know, if that is seen as something the city wants to maintain for a long, long time, then maybe it's worth the risk of hopefully renting out the bottom floor. Because that's what we're talking about here.
Yeah.
Residential will go like hotcakes in any market, probably. So it's that first floor, there's your risk, and maybe there's enough things to justify.
When you talk about risk on the first floor, one of the things I think is important to consider on that is your risk is not the structure and the build out. Your risk is just the shell, because you wouldn't build that out until you had a tenant on that. So you really are about 125 foot associated with that, which is $1.3 million. So to me, if you're going to go two floors on that, that's the risk, the financial risk to the city on that. That's how I would equate that, as opposed to adding the additional build out.
I think that's totally accurate. Yeah.
So as a CIC, if we're going to kind of move something to the council, are we asking for three scenarios or two here? Are we talking about two or two and a half as a low end?
Yeah.
Versus four at the high end.
Maybe three total, with two and a half being.
But I think it's really two and a half, because.
I think if you're going to go two, you might as well go two and a half.
Okay.
Because you're really then more on line with what you're saying is it's an amenity more than a money generator.
Right. Right. Wait, you've laid it out, Ken. It's easy. You just add another line item for the open air, rooftop, whatever. Add or delete it, and you can see how it affects the numbers here. So we'd have three total options.
Right. They're really kind of two, but you're right.
And a four.
And with that, we show ownership versus joint venture? Or you're saying not go there?
I'm not hearing anybody say without joint
venture. I would certainly show everything. For sure.
I say
recommend one model. Yeah. And show both.
Right.
And council may say, no, we want to go JV.
Right.
But recommend.
Yeah.
And keep in mind too,
in
all likelihood, after public input and council input as a whole, it'll come back to us anyway.
Yeah.
At that point if that's something they want to explore further.
Okay, to your question earlier, does the CIC need to spend another meeting looking at the JV aspect, or we kind of
maybe we don't. I mean, sounds like there's consensus on Loveland, at least recommendation-wise, Loveland owning and developing the project. We also talked about a two-story, a two-plus-a-roof four-story recommended, so I guess we're kind of recommending kicking out the three-story, okay? Was there anything else, I guess, those are the two big items I saw, was there anything else that would go into that recommendation that we need to talk about today, at this point? I think there's the big items, so maybe we could go with a vote to pass along a recommendation, keep things rolling, at least get the public input, all that other good stuff, you know, in process. Understanding that things done.
Well, you have the information now on the two and a half.
Yes.
Ken's gonna have to run it.
Yeah, but that would be included in that recommendation.
I wouldn't want to get it to council until we get that.
No, that's why we, yeah, you said you could do that pretty quickly, right? So that could be part of the recommendation, right? Did I understand that?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, well, does someone want to make a motion? I guess what I just said, in terms of the recommendation, but there's really those two pieces, the ownership and then the various options that we recommend council consider, so. Somebody want to make a motion?
I will make a motion that we move forward with making a recommendation to city council regarding the city owning the repurposed city hall with options for a 2, 2.5, or 4-story structure.
And I would add on there, not only recommending it to city council, but also recommending the city council also set a public hearing so we can have public input on it.
I agree.
That was 2, 2.5, or 4?
Correct.
Yes.
Yeah, the 3 is out.
Gosh.
Right there, chips, so chips.
And a second component to that motion is opening up for public discussion.
Right.
Council set up.
Yeah, council may set a public hearing as well. So that.
To see public input on the project. A second to that motion.
A second.
Okay, thank you. Any discussion on the motion? Okay. Let's do a voice vote on this one.
Aye.
Corey's aye.
Yes.
Pam's aye.
Yes.
Aye.
Oh, Jay, aye. 5-0, motion carries.
Ken, thank you very much, that was.
Thank you, Ken.
Yeah, really, it was great work, thank you.